The Battle of Shiganshina District is an amazing battle or war. Hajime Isayama uses certain writing techniques to make this battle so tense, thrilling, and surprising. I will go over the techniques and every single instance that they are used in this battle. The first is that new events keep happening in rapid succession, creating a fast pace for the war. This can be seen all over the war, so I won't specify any moments. But the other techniques are much more interesting. The second technique is establishing information. This arc establishes specific details that can be used in the near future to set up a plot twist or switch up and adapt the tactics that each side is using. AOT establishes the goal of the Survey Corps, which is to have Eren seal the gates. The warrior's goal is established to be capturing Eren in previous arcs. Armin deduces that three people are on the warrior's side. This gives us some kind of insight into who the enemies are. When Eren seals the wall, he is still active, which will be used later. Reiner introduces the new ability of moving his consciousness to a different part of the body to survive fatal attacks. The information also reveals that the enemies had a lot of time to prepare. When Zeke transforms, a row of titans can be seen standing around him. Erwin notices a titan on all fours and deduces that it didn't just transform and could have been an enemy scout that warned the others, which would explain how they had time to prepare. When Erwin gives orders, the thunder spears are shown and implied to be effective against the armored titan. How they are used is explained in a flashback before their actual usage. After the Colossal Titan's explosion, it is assumed that only the main six survived the attack. During the suicide charge, Eren can be seen being hit in the stomach and falling down. As the battle continues, Armin notices that Bert got skinnier due to his steam attacks. This detail was also set up the first time Reiner and Bert captured Eren. On the Armored Titan side, Mikasa establishes that they only have 3 Thunder Spears left to kill him. From the previous arc and this battle, it is established that the soldiers have an injection that will turn a person into a titan. After Armin is burned, he is shown to be still breathing. The third technique is building tension. Along with the fast pace, the buildup of tension keeps the audience on the edge of their seats and allows the story to explode with an epic reveal. Armin finds proof that the warriors are close. The tension is increased by the fact that no titans can be seen. We are also shown Reiner and Bertolt watching, but not where they are hiding. When Eren seals the first hole, the plan is going too smoothly, increasing the tension. Armin finds more proof that they are close. The soldiers searching along the wall with the possibility of the enemy hiding within them increases the tension. When Reiner roars, what he's signaling is unknown. When the soldiers go to attack Reiner, they find him lying on his back, preventing them from finishing him off. The expectation that something bad is about to happen is utilized when Bert uses his explosive transformation. When there are only 6 remaining to stand against the Colossal Titan, they realize that they have to defeat him on their own to avoid a pincer attack against them. When the Thunder Spears fail on Bertolt, Reiner gets back up. At the same time, Zeke is launching stones at the soldiers facing him. The situation is nearly hopeless. When Sasha misses her Thunder Spear, tension is built, because we knew that they only had 3 left and that all 3 needed to be used in order to kill Reiner. The fourth technique is setting up and executing plot twists. A plot twist needs to have some kind of foreshadowing so that it is believable. A lot of established information is used for the plot twists. Due to Armin's deduction, the possibility of an enemy hiding in the walls was set up. The setup and tension was capitalized upon when Reiner shows up and kills a soldier. Because Armin establishes that there were 3 cubs, we could come to the conclusion that it was Reiner, Bert, and Zeke. The story capitalizes on this by executing the plot twist of the Beast Titan and his army waiting outside. Erwin says that the Titan on all fours is intelligent. This leads to the plot twist that it was also a Titan Shifter later on. Reiner's newly established consciousness moving allows him to survive the Thunder Spear's attack and call for someone later. Earlier, we saw Bert hiding somewhere, and later we are shown the Cart Titan was carrying barrels. This information is utilized to execute the plot twist of the Colossal Titan surprise attack. When the explosion happens, a soldier can be seen jumping to cover Hanji, so when she shows up later, it is somewhat believable that she would have survived. Before Armin executes his plan with Eren, he tells him that neither of them can die because they are going to see the ocean together. He even throws in that he's never lied to him, so when he sacrifices his life to allow Bertolt to be taken down, it comes as a surprise. But it also could be predicted that he would do this because he said it depends on how much I can take, implying that he plans to wear off the Colossal Titan's flesh. And seeing how dangerous it was earlier, the viewer could predict that he might die in the process. Armin and Eren discuss a plan, and the attack titan falls down. The plan to decrease Bert's flesh and steam was already established, so when Armin sacrifices his life for seemingly nothing, it only makes sense that the plan was for Eren to launch a sneak attack. Additionally, the fact that Eren can still be active after just using his Titan was established at the start of the battle. The fifth technique is the changing plans and tactics. The way both sides deploy their troops, use their unique abilities and weapons to their advantages, and are forced to continually respond and adapt to the opponent's decisions is amazing. To protect Eren from being spotted, they are all wearing hoods once again. Because of the cups, the mission is halted so that the soldiers can search for the enemy. They switch to searching in the walls due to Armin's suggestion. The warriors' initial plan was for Reiner to attack from inside of the walls and Zeke from outside. Zeke also cuts off their escape route, forcing the soldiers to stay and fight. Zeke plans to further remove any escape options by sending the Titans at the horses, which would cage the soldiers in. Erwin responds by sending 3 squads to protect the horses and 2 squads to attack Reiner. He assigns Levi the task of killing the Beast Titan. Reiner climbs the walls and has the objective of killing the horses and then escaping. The soldiers respond by bringing out the attack Titan. Eren pretends to escape, forcing Reiner to focus on him rather than the horses. Eren also fights away from the wall to prevent Bert from interrupting again. Using the established Thunder Spears, the soldiers' goal is to surround Reiner and kill him once Eren provides the opportunity. They start with the eyes, then go to the nape. After Reiner roars, Zeke launches Bert to detonate, but he's unable to when he sees that he might kill Reiner too. Bert buys enough time for Reiner to lay on his back to protect him from the upcoming explosion. Bert's transformation wipes out most of the soldiers assigned to attack the armored Titan. His next plan is to burn down Shiganshina with burning houses. With the map of the battlefield, Armin's squad is forced to defeat Bert immediately. Zeke attacks the soldiers facing him with a storm of rocks. Erwin initially responds by hiding, but later, using the horses they protected, he retaliates with a suicide charge that hives Levi and gives him the chance to get to the Beast Titan by using the established row of Titans. Eren tries to stop Bert from going to the wall, but he is launched far away. The squad tries to attack with Thunder Spears, but Bert's team counters it. Using the established information, Armin creates a plan of Eren pretending he's out of the game, while he himself reduces the flesh and steam of the Colossal Titan, allowing Eren to surprise attack from behind. For the Armored Titan, the strategy uses the info of the amount of Thunder Spears. 2 spears will be used to blow up the jaw, and 1 spear will be shot into the Titan's mouth, killing Reiner. This plan immediately goes wrong when Sasha misses. When Mikasa is about to go for her shot anyway, Hanji shows up to blast the other side of the jaw, allowing the plan to be successful. And for the final events, Erwin being still alive is believable due to his specific damage being shown. We also know that Armin is alive, because he was shown breathing earlier. Finally, we know that there is only 1 injection and 1 Titan Shifter available to be eaten. So when the last decision has to be made, the tenth scene has all the information previously set up to make everything plausible and the scene incredible. In conclusion, the Battle of Shiganshina District uses rapid plot developments, establishing information, building up tension, setting up and executing plot twists, and constantly changing tactics to create this spectacular war.